Hello everyone. In this session, I will cover how to secure your web application using Azure Web Application Firewall. My name is Ashish Sharma and I am Microsoft MVP. Currently, I am working as Technical Advisor at Siteco. I am certified Azure and Kubernetes Administrator. I am having an experience of 6+ years in cloud computing and Microsoft Azure. The agenda of the meeting is today I will discuss about security issues, then I will cover Azure Web Services and its future. I will go through WAF, Azure Networking Services, and then I will show you a demo how to assign WAF policy on Azure Front Door. Security issues are becoming a day-to-day struggle for online web application. The number of security attacks occurring each year has been increased. In one of the recent security research suggests that most companies have poor networking infrastructure in place, which make them vulnerable to security issues. The average cost of a data breach is $3.86 million as of 2020. The healthcare industry lost an estimated $25 billion to ransomware attacks in 2019. Phishing attacks account for more than 80% of reported security incidents. There are various technologies available which can mitigate the risk of security attacks. One of the most effective is the Web Application Firewall, which provides centralized protection for your web application. Azure Web Application Firewall is a cloud-native service that protects your web application from bot attacks and common web vulnerabilities such as SQL injection and cross-site scripting. Now let's discuss about key features of Azure Web Application Firewall. The first key feature of Azure Web Application Firewall is managed rules. The rules that Azure WAF uses to detect and prevent attacks are created, maintained, and updated by Microsoft security team. If a rule changes or core rule set is modified, Microsoft updates Azure Web Application Firewall rules. Second feature is custom rules. If the managed rule offered by Web Application Firewall does not cover a specific threat to your web application, you can create your own custom rule. Next feature is WAF mode. Azure Web Application Firewall can operate in two WAF modes. First is detection mode, second is prevention mode. Detection mode logs requests that violate a rule, while prevention mode logs and block requests that violate a rule. Next feature is exclusion list. You can configure Azure Web Application Firewall to ignore a specific attribute when it checks any request. Next feature is policies. You can combine a set of managed rules, custom rules, exclusion, and other WAF setting into a single element called WAF policy. You can then apply that policy to multiple web apps for easy management and maintenance. Next and the last feature is request size limit. You can configure WAF to flag requests that are either too small or too large. Now we will discuss about a difference between Azure WAF and Azure Firewall. Azure Firewall operate at the network layer 4, that is transport layer, and make processing decision based on network address, ports, protocols, which protect data transfer and network traffic, but not application. Azure Firewall does not protect from application level, while Azure WAF protects web application by not only operating at layer 4, but also targeting HTTP and HTTPS traffic, taking advantage of working at layer 7, which is application layer. As we have noticed that in the introduction, WAF protects your web application from malicious attacks and common web vulnerabilities such as cookie manipulation, SQL injection, and cross-site scripting. Now we will discuss about WAF for Azure Networking Services. Azure Web Application Firewall can be deployed with Azure Application Gateway, Azure Front Door, and Azure Content Delivery Network service from Microsoft. WAF that has a features that can be customized for each specific service. Azure Application Gateway and Azure Front Door have some overlapping functionalities, as both services can be used to terminate HTTP and HTTPS load balance across backend server. The main difference between Application Gateway and Front Door is that Front Door is a global service, whereas Application Gateway is a regional service. This means Front Door gives you the ability to define, manage, and monitor the global routing for your web traffic across regions, while Azure Application Gateway works in just one region. Front Door is a global service using software-defined networking. The SSL certificate configuration are stored here and deployed to Microsoft Edge location and around the world. It is also possible to combine both services. You can use Front Door for global load balancing and Application Gateway at regional level. You can also deploy Web Application Firewall on Azure CDN, but currently WAF on Azure CDN from Microsoft is currently in public preview. Now let's have a demo on how to configure WAF policy on Azure Front Door and Application Gateway.
In this demo, we will configure WAF policy on the top of Front Door. For that, we will create an app service, then we will create Azure Front Door on the top of app service and assign a WAF policy to Front Door. So we are creating an app service. I have selected my existing subscription and I will create a new resource group. I will give a unique name to my web app. And select a runtime step. I will select the nearby region. I will create a new app service plan for my web app. And now I will select app service plan size. In this demo, I am selecting a free tier app service plan, but I would recommend for the production environment you can select app service plan from here. For the monitoring purpose, I'm creating a application inside. Some time to complete the app service deployment, so let's wait for some time. Our app service has been created, so let's go to resource and then we will navigate the app service line. app service has been started and it's up and running. So now we will create a Azure front door, which will be on the top of our front Azure app service. Search for front door here in the marketplace. And click on create button. Now we will select the existing resource group. Click on contribution. Now we will create a front end for our front door. On add button now. Now we will configure the backend pool. And we will select the app service here. Since we have only one app service, so it is coming up here. And now we will add this app service in our backend pool. Now we will configure the rules for our front door. I'm not changing the default configuration and I'm clicking on add button. Once it is done, you can click on review plus create button. Now it will take some time to create Azure front door. Now our front door has been created, so we will go to resource. And let's navigate to the page of front door. It should hit the page of our Azure web app. So our front door is hitting the page of web app. So now it is working fine. Our front door is working fine. Now we will create a WAF policy and assign that WAF policy to Azure front door. So for that, we will create, go to Azure Marketplace and search for WAF. We will select the policy, so we can select a policy for front door application gateway and CDN. Here we are creating a WAF policy for front door. You can select a SKU for front door premium and standard, but currently they are in the preview. I'm selecting Azure front door SKU. Now you can select a subscription. We will select an existing source group. The location of the WAF policy will be the same of the source group. This is the location of our resource group location. Policy name will be WAF policy. Let's click on policy settings. Let's select a mode, WAF mode for the prevention, and write the message here. So whenever the WAF will block any request, so the client will see this message. Click on manage modes. These are the manage rules configured in the WAF. We will select a Microsoft board manage rule as well. So you can see the default rule set are here, while Microsoft board manager rule set are here. Let's click on custom rules. You can configure your custom rule here. Click on add custom rule and configure all the custom rules here. not creating any custom rule. So let's click on association. Here we will assign the WAF policy with our front door. So click on add front door host. Here we will select our existing front door and select our front end host. Now click on create button. Now the WAF policy will be created and it will assign to our Azure front door. It will take some time, so let's wait for that. So our WAF policy has been created, so let's go to resource. As you can see, our association is gone. This is Fendor SKU. We have a policy setting that the WAF mode is prevention. We have added a message here. Our management policies are configured here. We don't have any custom rules. Now let's go to the Azure Fendor and let's see the configuration of WAF there. I have selected a front door and let's go to web application firewall. As you can see, our front door front end host is attached with the WAF policy. Now the WAF policy is assigned with Azure front door. So whenever there will be any malicious request, it will be blocked with WAF and customer or the client will see the message that we have mentioned in our WAF policy. Now let's check whatever malicious request will come, how our WAF and AFT will react. So let's navigate to the page of Azure Front Door and let's type a SQL injection and try to attack, make a SQL injection attack. As you can see, I have just hit a URL with SQL injection attack and we can see that a message has come that your request is blocked. It means whenever a malicious request will come, here I have added a SQL injection attack. So we will see a message, your request is blocked, and this kind of malicious request will be blocked by the WAF in Azure Front Door. And now we will create the application gateway and assign a WAF policy there as well. So for that, I will create application gateway. Select our existing resource group. Now let's select the nearby region. Application gateway also has their SKU as WAF, so we can enable the WAF we do here as well. And change the firewall mode to the prevention. And for the application gateway WAF, we need a virtual network, so we will create a virtual network now. Application gateway will also require a public IP, so we are creating a new public IP. In the backend pool, we will add our app service. Now we will create a routing rule. And also a HTTP setting. And next, we will click on Create button. Our application gateway deployment has been started, so let's wait for some more time. Our application gateway has been created, so we will go to the resource group and see the application gateway configuration. Let's open application gateway. As you can see, it is on the top of Azure Web App, so whenever we will open the IP address of application gateway, it should hit the web page of our web app. It is running fine and it is hitting the web page of our application. It is hitting the app service web page. So now we will create a WAF policy for application gateway. As you can see, application gateway also has their own WAF modules, and we have already enabled and the WAF mode is prevention mode. But we will create a WAF policy again for application gateway WAF, as the WAF policy is coming up with more number of rules. They have a custom rule as well. So let's assume you might have a scenario where some of the requests are getting blocked from some malicious requests are coming from a specific country. Then you should use this WAF policy, and you should use the WAF policy and associate that WAF policy with application gateway. So let's create a WAF policy. Here we will select the WAF policy for regional WAF and select the existing resource group. Go to policy settings, select the move to the prevention mode, and here we can add exclusion if you want to do it. Let's click on manage rule. As you can see, the manage rules are here. The OWASP rule 3.3. Is in the previous state, we are selecting the 3.1 rule. You can select the Microsoft Port Manager rule as well here. Next state, click on custom rule. I'm not creating a custom rule, but if it is required, you can click on add custom rule and create a custom rule here. Let's click on association and add association with application gateway WAF. Application gateway. And let's click on application gateway. Since application gateway has their own WAF P2 module, so we will click on this checkbox so that it will override the WAF policy that is associated with application gateway, and it will use the WAF policy that we are creating. Now click on review create. It will review it and then it will create the WAF policy. Let's wait for the creation of WAF policy. WAF policy has been created, so let's go to the WAF policy, and it is here like associated application gateway WAF as well. Let's go to application gateway and let's see the configuration of web application firewall. So we can see WAF policy is assigned with our application gateway.
In this session, we have configured Azure WAF policy on front door and application gateway. We have also found out how Azure WAF can protect your web application from cyber attack and web vulnerabilities. So if you have any question related to this session, please scan this QR code and I will reach out to you as soon as possible. I hope you find this session useful and informative. Thanks for attending this session. Have a good day. Thank you.